So then he says, Your Honor, I'd like to cite Wilkins versus Alexander.
He did it.
Oh, he did.
But that's the wrong case.
Not even close.
Goodness, who was on the bench?
O'Brien.
Oh. Oh, brother.
Yeah, I thought you'd remember that.
No mercy, O'Brien. How could I ever forget him?
Well, now this poor guy will never forget. You've had 5 weeks, counselor, 5 weeks, right in front of the jury like he's a first-year law student. And speaking of 5 weeks.
Hey, guys.
If you're going to be a June bride.
Did everybody sleep okay?
Have you booked a room yet?
Hi, Buster. Buster Sergeant McGee's dog.
Have you chosen your bridesmaids?
This is his first time away from home.
Hired a band.
Sergeant McGee said he's a very picky eater.
How about reserving the church?
So I'm feeding him a pro-system diet. Highly digestible. All the proper protein and calcium levels. Low sodium. And it tastes good, too.
Well, I'm just so happy for Buster. Dana. If we don't actually get married this time, I will never recover from the professional embarrassment. I will never make partner. I will be destined to a life of ambulance chasing and small claims court. I told everybody, the wedding is in June, and I want it to be. I want us to be married.
Phil, I'll take care of the wedding. Really.
You'll be my June bride?
I have plenty of time.
Okay.
I want you to make partner.
And you were a lawyer, you wanted that too. I call you from the office.
Oh, I won't be here. I've got a private lesson with the Miller's collie.
Miller? He's a printer, right?
Phil.
What? When you're there, you can do the invitations.
Go. White wicker furniture.
The hotel we went to.
Oh, in Charleston.
The guy behind the front desk.
Oh, with the red nose.
His name really was Rudolph, huh?
Anyway, I picked out the wallpaper for the sunroom.
It's nice.
Oh, really good. I want you to like it.
Do.
So I'm going over to the Rankins. Dorothy wants me to do her living room. And I'm going to invite them to the engagement party.
Did they come to the last one?
No, they came to the first one.
Oh, yeah, right, the first one.
I wish I was inviting them to the wedding.
Oh, we will. We will.
Are you going to the station?
Yeah, in 10 minutes.
Will you roll it into the garage before you leave?
And shut the door. I will.
Crazy. I'm crazy for I'm so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me.
Ah! Gary, it's Mike. Listen, I was just in an accident. 3 miles down Old Mill Road. Car's off the side of the hill. Driver is trapped. The engine is smoking. Get here.
Dispatch Engine 15 is responding to vehicle accident, possible injury. Car is 3 miles south of Glen on Old Mill Road. Off-duty firefighters on the scene. We'll be there in 5 minutes.
Copy that. Who is it?
It's Mike.
Hang on!
Help me!
Hang on!
Somebody help
I'm coming!
Me.
I'm here, I'll help you. Now listen to me. I'm gonna cut the seatbelt, all right? Put you down. Okay.
My eyes hurt.
Hang on, it's almost cut. Easy. Easy. All right, there you go. Easy. Come on down.
I'm cut. I'm caught.
Right.
I'm caught.
That's all right.
I'm caught.
All right, the door. Door's smashed in. Don't try to move it. I call the fire department. They're right up the road. They'll be here any minute.
Please don't leave me.
No, no, I'm not going anywhere, okay?
All right. I can't see. I can't see.
Okay. There's a lot of smoke. Just keep your eyes closed. A little dirt, a little bit of blood. Paramedics will flush them out when you get here.
The dog.
Yep.
Did you see that dog?
Yeah. It's a Dalmatian right in the middle of the road.
Did I hit him?
No, no, no. He ran off. He's okay. Like dogs, huh?
I love dogs.
Yeah, me too. You know, I used to have a little mutt when I was a kid. His name was Red.
I hit her, a retriever, a lady.
It's all right, hang on. I got you. Oh, it's easy, easy, easy. Easy. Okay. Where do you wish you were right now?
What?
Just relax, keep breathing, and tell me where you wish you were.
Anywhere.
Yeah, I believe you. But if you could be anywhere, picture yourself. Exactly, where would you be?
I don't know what you mean.
Let's see. Just, 25 years from now, if you could be anywhere in the world, where would you be?
My anniversary party.
Your anniversary party? Married?
Not yet. Are you?
No. No, not yet. So, at this anniversary party, who's at that party?
The kids.
What are their names?
The boys are Sam and Charlie.
Those are good names. Let's see the girls. How about Kate, Jesse?
That sounds good.
Thank you.
What's the best thing about being married for 25 years?
My husband. Oh, they say for better or worse, but with us, it just keeps getting better and better. He's my best friend. What about you?
My wife. After 25 years, I still can't get her out of my mind. She's everything to me.
What do we got? All right, let's start. Grab the cutter out.
Stevie, pull it back easy, man. Easy.
Jam, man.
Put the jaws into it.
Got it. I got a good fight.
Okay, guys. Get out of here. Okay, come on. Easy, easy. Easy. All right.
Yeah,
you're almost
tight.
Free.
Keep it tight.
Hang on.
Got it.
Almost there.
Got it. No, he's good.
Okay, she's free.
All right, get you out of here.
Come on.
All right, easy. Come on, I got you.
Easy. Keep it braced under there.
How is she?
She's alert. Full range of motion. No apparent back or neck injury. She got some cuts from the glass, okay? Need to be flushed out. Paramedics on their way?
Yeah, 2 minutes.
Okay, let's go right out of here.
William.
Yeah, there's one more shop down there. Oh, my goodness.
Are you still there? Are you still there?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Ma'am, we need you to lie down and be still, okay? 10-minute ride to the hospital. I'm gonna take a look at your eyes on the way.
Wait. Please go with me. Please hold my hand.
I'm right here. I'm with you.
Gary called. Told us what happened.
I'm fine.
Told us it was a miracle no one got hurt bad. Or worse.
Just in her car?
Oh.
Mom, I'm fine. Thanks.
Yeah, Mom was pretty worried.
So was I. She was seeing the other driver.
What about you, Mike? Mom was worried about you.
I'm fine.
And what are you doing here, you wimp? Why aren't you work?
I took the day off.
Oh, you call yourself a firefighter? We called Tina. She's on her way. She dropped by this morning. Showed me the wallpaper you're gonna put in the sunroom. Mike, the wallpaper for the sunroom? Tina showed it to me. It's perfect.
It's flowers.
You have no taste at all. You know that, Mike?
Did Gary mention her name?
Who?
The woman in the accident.
You didn't find out her name?
No, we didn't talk to each other on the way to the hospital. I just held her hand. When we got there, they took her away. And I had to talk to the police. I gotta find her. I just want to make sure she's all right. You know, just make sure she's all right.
Police said they hadn't seen one like that in a long time. They couldn't believe you came out of that car in one piece.
It's a miracle, Dana, that I lived, that you look so good without makeup.
A couple of cuts and a bruised ankle. It really is unbelievable. It turned out to be your lucky day. I'll see you after work. Oh, and I don't want you to worry about anything. I'm going to take care of the wedding.
Oh, no, Phil.
You just concentrate on getting better. I'll see you later. Bye, Lucy.
See ya.
Please phone social services.
Well, looks like there may actually be a wedding after all. Okay.
I don't know his name. The police who came here weren't the same ones who spoke to him.
Weren't the ones who spoke to who?
Oh, the man who saved me. Listen, I was trapped. And he stayed with me, and he held me in his arms. He talked to me. If it wasn't for him, I don't know. But he said I would be okay. I have to find him. To thank him. I just need to thank him.
Now, he is the vice president of the Norwich Bank and Trust Company, and she's on the board of the Garden Club, and you say...
The Garden Club? Wow. Do kids get to go?
They collect stamps and coins and butterflies and all kinds of interesting things. See, collecting is their hobby. And you say...
I've always wanted to start a collection.
Now, he plays the flute, and she plays a cello. And often after dinner, they accompany each other in the den. And you say...
Is it too late for me to learn to play the piano?
Yes.
I like movies a lot. Do you?
Oh, yes, we do. We like comedy. Anything with Billy Crystal.
Oh, that man just makes us laugh out loud. I think When Harry Met Sally, that's our all-time favorite.
What about you, Corey? What's your all-time favorite?
Night of the Living Dead. It's a classic. I love that part where those little kids come back to life, all gross and bloody, and then they kill their mother with a garden hoe. They keep on stabbing her and stabbing her, and she's screaming the entire time, but they don't stop until she's dead. And then they eat her guts. Oh man, that's so great. I think about it all the time.
Well, I thought they were perfectly fine.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't. But no one's gonna adopt you unless you let them.
I want real parents. I don't want to be adopted.
But you were adopted. Your parents adopted you.
I was a baby. That doesn't count. I want my parents. Mm-hmm. I have a mother somewhere. Somebody gave birth to me, didn't they?
Yes.
Who?
I don't know.
A fire station is not a playground, and this is not recess. It's a field trip, and we expect you to behave accordingly, okay? All right, Mrs. Dent's class, Miss McCloy's class on the first bus, Mrs. Gibson's class, and Mr. Schumann's class on the second bus. Here we go.
I get the window
seat. Hey, no pushing, please.
I was born in Seattle. It says so on my birth certificate.
Mother's name's not on it?
No, just my parents' names. They adopted me right after I was born.
So what are you going to do?
First, I'm going to go find her.
How?
My foster mom's going to help me. She knows this place called the National Reunion Registry. That's what they do. Help adopted kids and their birth parents find each other.
Okay, so you find her. Then what?
Then I go see her. Live with her. What else?
What if she's still in Seattle? Or California? That's 3,000 miles away. How are you gonna get there?
I don't know. Bus, I guess. Train?
That costs money. A lot of money.
I have to get a job.
You're 10 years old. Who's gonna hire you?
Say cheese.
Cheese.
All right. Helmets and jackets right here. Watch your step on the way down.
Oh, yeah. Hey, thanks.
You're welcome.
What's your name?
Corey Shea. What's yours?
Mike Grant.
So you're the captain?
That's me.
Are you hiring anybody now?
Well, you look pretty good in that fireman's helmet, but don't you think you're a little bit young to be a firefighter?
I'm way too young. I'm a kid. I mean to help out, clean up and stuff, hang around like a bat boy.
That's Roger's job over there. Besides, I'm not allowed to hire anybody. That's the county's job. Hey, why don't you talk to your parents, huh? Need some work for them after school. Hit them up for a couple extra bucks.
I'm a foster kid. I don't have any parents. That's why I need a job. I'm trying to save up money so I can go see my real mom. I haven't seen her in sort of a pretty long time.
Hey, Corey Shea, wait a minute. Like cars? I'm rebuilding the engine of an old Thunderbird in my house.
What year?
66 convertible.
That's the one Thelma and Louise drove off the cliff. I know all the movie cars.
Tell you what do you say? After school, a couple days a week? $5 an hour?
Police can't find the report. They said it's in transit between departments. They don't know his name, but they said they'd get back to me.
No? Maybe you imagined him. No. He's real.
Nope. You should hire someone part-time until your ankle gets better.
I just put a sign out on the fence not 5 minutes ago.
Hey.
Hey!
I have two things to tell you. First, I booked the church. June 28th will finally be Mrs. Dana Davis.
And the second thing?
Oh, there's a guy who wants to apply for the job. Says he rides by the kennel every day, saw the sign, looking for a couple afternoons a week.
Does he have any experience?
No, but he knows every dog that was ever in the movies. Come on in.
Nurse Stratton, please report to pediatrics. Nurse Stratton, please report to pediatrics.
Yes?
Yes, I am looking for some information about a patient, a woman. She was in a car accident a couple days ago on Old Mill Road. The car flipped over, was on fire. She was trapped inside.
And the firefighter rescued her. Yes, I remember that one.
Is she here?
They kept her overnight for observation, then sent her home.
Oh.
Is there something else?
Her name. I'd like to know her name.
Personal patient information is available to family members only.
But I'm the firefighter.
Then you should know better.
But I'm the one who pulled...
I'm sorry, but it's against the rules.
Excuse me. Excuse me, Nurse Ryan? My name is Mike Grant. I'm a firefighter. I pulled a young lady out of a burning car the other day. I was just trying to find out if she's okay.
Do you know what room she's in?
Actually, they sent her home.
I'm not supposed to.
I know I'm not a family member, and I know it's against the rules. But I'm the firefighter who pulled her out of the burning car. And I held her hand in the ambulance. And, well, please, if you could just help me out this one time, I'd just like to know her name and number. Please. Sorry, I gotta go, but if you get that information, could you call me at this number, please? Thank you very much.
Picture it. Light coming through the stained glass windows, 300 people whispering how beautiful you look.
300 people?
Remember we went to Steve Graham's wedding when you were still working?
I am still working.
As a lawyer, sweetheart. Remember how big that wedding was? How much you liked that?
That was 4 years ago.
Exactly my point. 4 years from now, you're going to look back on this and say, wow, that was incredible.
Phil, where are you going to put 300 people?
Cutter's Inn.
Cutter's Inn?
Bob Nelson's daughter got married there. He made a phone call for me. You can't just book a place like Cutter's Inn at the last minute, you know.
It is the most expensive place in the county.
Yeah.
How are we gonna pay for that?
We'll work it out. Come on, cheer up. This is your wedding. You're gonna love it. I gotta go. I'll see ya.
Come on, buddy. I want to get married down by the river. Everybody camping out. Roasting marshmallows on a stick.
We probably don't have marshmallows on a stick at Cutter's Inn.
Probably not.
Hey, Sarge.
You know how they say people look like their dogs? Well, he can put his uniform on Buster, send him to work. No one would know the difference.
So how'd he do?
Oh, he ate like a champion.
Well, then give me two bags of whatever you're feeding him. One for him, one for me.
You got it.
What happened to you?
Oh, I was in a car accident. Corey, would you go get Buster for Sergeant McGee?
Are you sure it's not Sergeant McGee for Buster?
I'm trying to find the man who pulled me out of the car. I never got his name.
Should be in the police report.
They can't seem to find it.
Vanished into that dark hole called Central Processing?
Sergeant, can you help me?
Hey, come here, boy. Come to Daddy. Come on. Come on. There's my boy. Here. Oh, come on. Let's just see you. You're a beautiful dog. Come on, here. Daddy kiss you. Oh, he's a good boy. Oh, he's a good boy. Oh, yeah. Good to see you. Yeah.
Hi, Lillian. This is Laura. Hi.
Hi, Laura. There are cookies in the kitchen.
She seems so nice.
She is nice.
Then why don't you stay with her? Isn't she like a mother?
She's more like Aunt Bee. Fresh cookies, homemade pie, fried chicken. I would live with her, but she's retiring, moving to Florida. To a senior's place. Did you see Cocoon? Me and Wolf of Brimley swimming in that pool. Don Amici diving in after us? I don't think so. I'm too young to retire.
Wow.
If it is a picture of some muscle beach guy with long hair and a lady in a really red dress, and they're both riding a horse on the beach, and you can tell by the look on their faces, whatever in that book is guaranteed to make you puke. Well, Lillian's the queen of those books. She's the queen of romance.
I like romance too.
Take my picture.
Now you take mine.
The reunion registry wants a current picture of me. I already gave them my birth date, where I was born, what my school was like, my adopted family, that kind of stuff.
Now what?
Now they find her, tell me where she is, and then I pack my suitcase.
Grilled beef tenderloin with Merlot sauce, oven roasted potatoes with orange zest, and braised carrots with thyme.
Sounds pretty involved.
Oh, well, it's all in the planning, honey. Besides, Paul said he'd help out.
What are you gonna start with?
A dilled shrimp and radicchio salad with apples and grapes.
Pearl onions with the tenderloin?
Yes, and portobello mushrooms.
You know, I got an idea. Why don't we just make a big pot of chili, bake up some cornbread, get a keg of Sam Adams, huh?
Michael, you can't serve chili at an engagement party.
Why not?
Well, because it's brown, for one thing.
You need some color on the plate.
It's true.
Cheese and onions, orange and white, those are your colors. Well, they were when I went to art school.
Honey, you just have to trust me when it comes to things like this.
Can you believe how lucky he is? I mean, this is just for the engagement party. Wait till she gets her hands on the wedding.
Oh, yeah. It's gonna be something.
When is the wedding?
Oh, I don't know yet. Captain Marvel here hasn't set a date.
Why not?
3 years they've been engaged.
3 years?
Last year, she served a grilled yellowtail tuna with caper anchovy sauce.
Honey, it's a Nurse Ryan. What does she want?
I'll find out.
What's for dessert?
Oh, poached pears with mascarpone cream and chocolate sauce.
Nurse Ryan? Yeah, hi, it's Mike. Great. Go ahead. Yeah? 829. Got it. Thank you. Thank you very much. Bye. Nina.
Have you thought about the length?
I don't want to train.
You look beautiful.
I don't even want a veil.
Trains are in, sweetheart. Everybody's wearing them.
You know what I was thinking? That I could just have a few flowers in my hair.
You know what it is? It's the dress. It's calling out for a train. You hear that? I need a train. I need a train.
Phil.
You're gonna be the most beautiful bride in Norwich, I promise.
Gloria, Valerie McFarland's here.
You'll have to excuse me for just a minute. That's Valerie McFarland of the Briarwood McFarlands.
I can't believe this.
Neither can I. You can't get a wedding dress anywhere on this kind of notice. You can't get one here, no matter how much notice you have. They have a 2-year waiting list. Stu Harrigan, one of the senior partners, 3 daughters. They all got their dresses here. He made a call for me. Spoke to Gloria.
It's gonna cost a fortune.
That's all right. When you're back practicing law, we'll have 2 salaries.
I'm not going back.
Dana, it's been 3 years. You're not making any money at the kennel.
Yes, I am.
You're barely making ends meet.
But my ends are meeting, Phil. They're definitely meeting.
But that's not enough to make you happy.
I'm happy. I love the kennel. I'm happy.
You know what this is? We're nervous, you know? That's okay. That's okay. I'm gonna go and see if they have any decaf, okay?
Dana Boyer. Sergeant McGee, hi. No, I'm not busy. Yeah, I have a pen. Oh, firefighter. Yeah. 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 Got it.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah, okay. Bye-bye. Mike.
How long have we known each other?
Since preschool.
And in all of that time, have I ever been wrong about men? Okay, besides that one kid in junior high.
Martin Redler.
Okay, I was wrong then, but I'm definitely not wrong now.
I just want to thank him.
Write him a letter.
Face to face.
Don't do it.
Why not?
Because on June 28th, they're going to marry Phil Davis. Esquire!
Well, and what does that have to do with anything?
See, I know what's going on here. I felt the same way right before I married Lenny.
You did?
Mm-hmm. I wanted to have a screaming, wild, passionate love affair, just like you do now.
That's what I want. I had no idea.
If you knock on that door, you can kiss your marriage goodbye, Dana.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, really? You know he's gonna invite you in, and you'll go. Because he's probably got those big, beautiful firefighter eyes that suck in, and you can't look away even if you wanted to. And then he'll lead you into the kitchen where he'll happen to have a bottle of wine in the fridge already open. And you'll talk. You'll talk about the accident and how he pulled you from the car, and there were flames all around the two of you, and you're so hot, burning up. You won't even make it to the bedroom. You'll just do it right there on the kitchen table.
Kitchen table.
You will have a torrid affair that ends with nothing, Dana. And Phil will leave you, make partner, and marry someone else, and live the happily ever after life that you were supposed to have. You'll spend the rest of your days alone, just you and the dogs, hanging out with me and Lenny and the kids. Forever. And ever. And ever, and ever, and ever, and ever.
Julie's having some kids over to her house on Saturday, and she said that you could come.
I don't know. Maybe.
We could go together.
What do you mean?
I mean, you and me, together. Huh?
Yeah, I talked to Paul this morning. Says he can find me a tricked out car.
Go, speed racer, go.
Says he knows a guy in Cleveland, knows a guy in Chicago. Anyway, it'll take about 3 weeks.
Call me tonight, Corey? I will.
Now look at this.
What?
Promise?
I said I will.
Bye.
Bye.
Call me tonight, Corey.
I think she likes you.
She loves me. She says it's true love.
Oh, true love. You hear that, Mike?
She believes it, too. Girls, they're the only ones who believe that kind of stuff.
Oh, I don't know, kid. You'd ask Mike here about that. You know, there was this girl in sixth grade. Joan Conway, blonde hair, blue eyes, the hottest babe in Mike's class. I was in fifth grade. She was a goddess.
I'm in fifth grade.
Oh, well, then you know what I'm talking about. So anyway, she and Mike were holding hands at recess, walking home together after school, playing a little spin the bottle.
Just the two of them?
You get the picture. She said that she wants to go steady, wear his ID bracelet.
And?
And he says no. The hottest girl in the school. Naturally, I'm all over him like glue, and he says that there's one true love out there somewhere just for him. And Joan's not the one.
One true love.
He's gonna meet her one day, he says. They'll fall in love together at first sight, and they'll spend the rest of their lives together.
Wow.
Wow is right, kid. From that day on, I knew there was something very wrong with my brother. Ask him.
So that's Tina, the one special girl somewhere in the world just for you?
Of course it's Tina.
You grew up here?
Oh, yeah, it was a farm then. My dad had a job in town, but he was a farmer too, in the mornings after work and on the weekends.
When did you make it a kennel?
No, he didn't. I did. After my mother passed away, about 3 years ago. My dad died when I was in high school. Oh, That's Lady. I didn't have any brothers and sisters, so Lady was my best friend. Well, Lucy, too. There you go, buddy. Come on. So, what are you gonna do with all that money?
I'm gonna go find my mom, my birth mom, and go see her. I was adopted when I was a baby. My parents got killed in a car accident when I was 7. I've been a foster kid since then. I don't have any brothers or sisters either. I have this dream that she answers the door and it's me. Somehow she knows that right away, that I'm her kid. And she hugs me and cries and asks me to live with her and be her son again. Is that a crazy dream?
No. Most kids have dreams like that. Well, not exactly like that, but big, important, wonderful dreams.
Did you? What?
No, I can't.
Yes, you can. Come on, Dana, tell me. Please?
Okay. When I was a kid, I dreamed that there was one true love in the world just for me. And I believed that if only I could look into his eyes, I would know it was him and he would know it was me and we would get married and live happily ever after. I can't believe I just told you that. I bet you've never heard anything like that before.
Actually, I have a friend who believes the exact same thing. He's engaged now.
So am I.
Is that what you saw when you looked into Phil's eyes?
That was a little girl's dream, Corey. Phil and I are two responsible adults who dated for a while and decided we could make a good life together.
That's what was in his eyes?
Oh. I can't believe it.
Oh, Tina, that looks fantastic.
Oh, thank you, Paul.
Hey, let me get some of those, huh?
Sure.
Oh,
nice.
They're beautiful.
Hello, could I speak with Dana, please?
No, I'm sorry, she's out. This is her fiancé, can I take a message?
Her fiancé?
Yes, can I take a message?
No message. Thank you anyway, thank you.
Hey, guys.
Hey,
nice to see you, man.
Hello, gorgeous. Thanks for coming. So what do you think, huh? She's funny, she's smart, she's a great cook. Been together a long time.
Mm-hmm. 10 years.
I'm a lucky man.
You are.
I like my job, my friends, Tina.
Is that right?
And what am I waiting for?
Only you can answer that, Mike.
Hey, Big Ron, how are you?
She wants to be a grandmother. She was just telling me.
Then why don't you do it?
Oh, no. I'm a confirmed bachelor. Oh, but you. You're so close to actually being a married man. All you have to do is set a date. Do it now. Big announcement, everyone goes crazy. They think you had it planned all along. You'll be a hero. Oh, look at her. Think how happy she'll be. Think how lucky you are. Come on. You can do it. Don't make her wait anymore.
Come on.
Darling.
Excuse us, everyone, please.
Okay, everybody here, come on in.
Okay. I know you all have been waiting for me to set a date, right? So, here goes. Tina and I are getting married on June 28th, and you're all invited.
June 28th?
It just came to me.
That's in 3 weeks, Mike. What kind of wedding can I put together in 3 weeks?
Chili cornbread and a keg of salmon. Oh.
It's been called Grant since I was a kid. Uh-huh. Officer McGee says it's been owned by the same family for 50 years.
I thought it was named for Ulysses. Like the tomb. Oh, you're really gonna do this?
Well, just running into him isn't the same as knocking on his door.
This isn't just running into him.
Well, I just happened to be here.
No. You just happened to plan the whole thing.
Only my part. You know, his part is the coincidence.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's your part I'm worried about. That could be his mother, don't you think? Oh, I think he's here. Did you tell him we were coming?
Might have mentioned it.
Lucy. Oh, your part's a coincidence. What's wrong with you? What were you thinking?
Oh, I don't know. I guess I was thinking that maybe you could just thank this guy for saving your life and then have a surprise lunch with your fiance. What were you thinking?
That. That's exactly what I was thinking.
What are you guys doing here? How you doing?
Hey.
Guess where I just was?
Barado Jewelers.
That is a very good guess.
Phil, no.
John McKenna, one of the senior partners, when he got married, all three times, he bought his rings there.
So I guess there are ex and current Mrs. McKinnon's walking around with rocks as big as Buicks.
So he knows Barado personally. He picks up the phone, he makes a call, he asks him to take care of me. And I asked him to take care of you.
Oh my God! Phil, I said a plain gold band.
Oh, well, there's gold under there, somewhere. You only get married one time, sweetheart.
Unless you're McKinnon.
That's nice.
Will you excuse me? I'll be back in a second.
Next week, she'll show it to everybody.
Could I get a pack of mints, please? Mm-hmm. I love these. Are you Mrs. Grant?
Yes.
By any chance, do you have a son who's a firefighter?
Yes, Mike. Do you know him?
Well, we met once. How's he doing?
Oh, fine. He's getting married on June 28th. Do I know you? There's something very familiar about you.
No, I don't think so.
Excuse me. Can I get the menu, please?
They want more information. Like what I like to do, what my family was like, personal stuff.
What does that mean?
They think I might have found her.
Are you sure?
Yep, it won't be long now.
Okay, because I don't want you to get your hopes up.
Why not?
Well, there's always a chance that, what if she's not looking for you?
Of course she's looking for me. It's not like she just dumped me on a park bench or something. She went to the hospital. She cared about me.
I know she did. It's just that I got my hopes up about something, and it turned out not to be true. I know how that feels, and I don't want that to happen to you.
What'd you get your hopes up about?
Uh-uh.
Come on, I'm a kid. Who am I supposed to tell?
It's silly. It's not important. It's silly.
I'm the king of silly. I live for silly. You have to tell me now.
A couple of weeks ago, I was in an accident. And this car was smoking and burning. And this man saved me.
And?
Oh, and he stayed with me, and he talked to me, and he held my hand. And I felt something that I'd never felt before.
I thought you said it was silly. That's not even a little silly. There's nothing silly about that at all. You told me not to get my hopes up, but I was hoping for something silly.
Okay. Is my hair silly? I started to believe that he might be the one. My one true love. Like I was in sixth grade or something.
It's not him?
No, he's getting married. Same day as me.
It's not Phil either.
Oh, Corey, it's complicated. I'm 30-something, and I don't want to keep waiting. I love Phil. I do, in a special way. It's just...
It's just that he's not your one true love. It's hard to write down what you're like.
Just say, good at school, likes movies, big brown eyes, very, very cute. That should do it. Where's Lillian?
Upstairs reading.
Romance?
What else?
With some Muscle Beach guy with long hair on the cover.
And a lady in a really red dress.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, guaranteed to make you puke.
Do you ever think about what she'll be like? Your mother, I mean.
Sometimes.
So, what's she like?
She's real. That's the main thing. She's not fake and full of it. I like her, even though she's my mom.
Does she work?
She runs her own business.
Where's she live?
In the country, on a small farm or something.
So, she likes animals?
Dogs. She loves dogs.
Last chance. Barbecue, softball game. Hey, we could get married at home plate.
You're wearing a tuxedo.
Oh.
So, how does it fit now?
It's perfect. I'm gonna go change.
Hi. Let me just finish with them, and I'll fit that for you, all right?
Thank you. Ah. Come on, try it on. Hi.
Hi. Are you getting married?
Yeah. Are you?
Yeah.
Next month.
Oh.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, you too.
Oh. Oh.
I hate it.
I love it.
It's uncomfortable.
It's gorgeous.
You know, it doesn't have a number on the back. I'm used to wearing something with a number, you know, like 24. Oh, excuse me. You're number 24. Mm-hmm. I'm only kidding.
Hey, 24, yes. Oh, look out. Last one, Mike.
Okay, all right. We got... Oh, yeah!
Firefighter saves woman in burning car. Wears lingerie under his turnouts.
Red's my color! Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. I just want to tell you from the bottom of my heart that this means absolutely nothing to me.
Yeah.
All right, I'll go on, get out of here, get back to work. Thank you, really appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
What did Joey mean? Firefighter saves woman from burning car?
Nothing. I was in a car accident a couple weeks ago. Nothing happened to me, but the other car flipped over and started to smoke and burn. And anyway, there was this woman trapped inside the car, and I stayed with her till the other guys came, and I held her hand, talked to her.
What?
Oh, nothing. It's just that I had these crazy feelings about her for a while. I thought that... forget.
No! What? You thought what? Joan Conway. That girl when you were a kid. She wasn't your one true love, but the woman in the accident. You thought it was her, right?
Well, you know what I found out? She's getting married, same as me. Told you it was crazy.
Oh my God. He's a lawyer, she likes dogs.
I know lawyers who like dogs. Or is it I know lawyers who are dogs?
You're not listening, Lily.
Yes, I am. He's a fireman and she's an interior designer. And she owns a kennel and he's a lawyer.
They're getting married for the wrong reason.
Just because you think so.
They're marrying the wrong people.
It doesn't mean that they think so.
But they do. They told me.
They told you that they were marrying the wrong people?
When they were kids, they both had this theory. All about romance.
Theory about romance?
They both believed that there was one person in the world just for them. And one day they'd meet, look into each other's eyes, and know that they were the one.
And they both believed this theory?
Since they were my age.
And they both know that the person they're marrying isn't their one true love?
And we were there when they met for the first time. The accident on Old Mill Road. He carried her up the hill to the ambulance.
I remember.
But she couldn't open her eyes, and they didn't tell each other their names, so they don't know who the other one is.
Oh, no.
But they can't forget about the accident. They keep thinking that the other person could be the one.
Both of them?
They told me.
Oh, my.
All they have to do is look into each other's eyes.
Oh, yes.
I can't let them marry the wrong people. I have to tell them.
Oh, no, no, Corey, sorry. You can't tell them.
I have to.
No, darling, no. No, these are people's lives we're talking about. I mean, there are other people involved here besides your friends. You can't interfere. You don't have that right. Promise me you will not tell them. Here, come with me. This is the Thornbirds. It's the Bible of romance. I want you to put your right hand on this book and promise me you will not tell them. Corey, please. It's very important.
I promise I won't tell them.
If it really is meant to be, they'll find each other. I mean, once it's put in motion, you can't stop true love.
At the end of each pew, there will be a beautiful arrangement of flowers.
It's a huge church. There's a lot of flowers.
Oh, yes, overflowing with beauty and color.
Neil O'Connell, one of the senior partners.
Armando did all his weddings.
Star gazers, Casablancas, Frisias, all white. Ecuadorian roses,
what about the fire
all red.
Extension? What?
Roses, all red. And French tulips, extra long in white and red.
Fire inspection. Remember the safety code. We talked about this, my friend.
We put three very large baskets on the altar with two candelabras on the side with tulips and lilies cascading down.
Oh, cascading. Nice.
So, now we have...
This is going to cost a fortune.
He'll do it for free.
I know what I'm doing.
He's a firefighter. He knows what he's doing.
As for the bridal bouquet.
This, I've got it here.
He'll check the smoke alarms.
Gardenias, stephanotis, and imported from Hawaii.
Hawaii? I always wanted to go there.
Beautiful pink anthurians and ventrobium orchids.
He'll check the fire extinguishers.
And this is just for the church, am I right?
Please say yes.
Yes, 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 yes.
I'll take care of everything.
Very good. Now, for the reception, I will get more spicy.
I'm sure you will, Armando. That sounds great.
I didn't say anything. I just put it in motion. It's a kennel in a barn.
It's going to burn down.
It's not going to burn down.
What if it does? What if it burns down because you didn't go to inspect it? What are you going to tell the newspapers? What are you going to say in court?
In court? What are you talking about? How did this get to be my fault?
Tell it to the judge, Mike. The jury will make an example of you. 7 to 10 with time off for good behavior.
7 to 10.
Don't worry. I'll come visit you.
Place used to be a farm.
How'd you know that?
I used to come here when I was a kid with my dad.
You've been here before?
Yeah. Yeah, pumpkins for Halloween, hay rides. Used to be this cute little girl, a little younger than me, selling tickets.
You must be the firefighter.
Yeah, how you doing?
I'm good. Hey.
I'm Mike.
I'm Lucy. Well, come on. I'm your tour guide.
Where's...
Oh, she's with Phil. He had to show her something. She won't be here.
This is never gonna happen.
Leaky, that's the car. Here we go. You okay?
Oh, yeah. Can I open my eyes now?
Good chat. Okay.
Where are we?
Rose Avenue. What do you think?
About what?
The house. Isn't it great?
Yeah, it's nice. Phil, what are we doing here?
I made an offer.
Why?
It's got 4 bedrooms, all new plumbing, all new electric. It's 5 minutes from the office.
No, I mean, why did you make an offer on it?
So we can live here after we're married.
We already have a house.
Dana, we talked about this.
Yes, and I said I wanted to stay in the farmhouse.
We talked about this.
Phil, talking is a two-step process. First talking, then listening. You never seem to get to the second step. It's all the first step with you. You don't talk about something with me. You talk at me about something.
I'm doing this for us so we can move up, have a great life. Isn't that what we want?
A great life, of course that's what I want.
So what's the problem?
The problem is, Phil, you are such a lawyer.
So are you.
No, I'm not.
Oh, listen to these guys.
That's a good band. Yeah, I like them.
Yeah, I like them too.
Great, Don. Okay.
Right.
Going on?
Oh, hey! Listening to wedding bands.
Oh, so cute. Is he the one from the station?
Nope.
Tell me you didn't buy a dog, Mike.
I didn't buy a dog. I got him for free from the pound. His name is Lucky.
I think this is where I go back to work.
Okay. I'm allergic to dogs.
And me too.
You never told me that.
Well, I'm not very allergic, but a little.
Same as me. Just a little.
Oh, look, he likes you.
Mike.
Come on, honey, he's cute.
I don't want a dog.
Well, I do.
You never wanted one before.
Yeah, well, I want a dog now.
I've already said no.
Honey, I want to keep the dog.
Okay, but only if he's housebroken.
Of course he's housebroken. Look at him, he's a good boy.
Hey, I'm so sorry. Hey,
get you some lessons, pal. Teach you how to behave inside the house. Maybe I'll get some lessons while I'm at it.
Yeah.
Hi, I'd like to... My dog... Mike.
I'm Dana.
Heel. Come on, heel. 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 There you go. Come on. Heel. Heel. Come around. Sit. Stay. Come here. That's a good boy. Sit. Give me your paw. Thank you. Good boy. Yeah. What a good boy you are.
So, what do you want me to do? Teach him calculus?
I don't believe that. He doesn't act like that inside the house. Oh, Tina won't let him back inside until he does.
Tina?
She's my fiance. I'm getting married at the end of next week. I'm 28th.
I'm getting married on the same day.
Really? What a coincidence.
Yeah, really.
Well, thank you very much. That was really terrific. I should be going.
Yeah, I better get back to work. So does your family still own the diner?
Yeah, but now it's just my mom and my brother.
I like that place.
Yeah.
My dad used to take me there for lunch on Saturdays when I was a kid. It was our weekend ritual. Oh, there was this little league team that would come in after their games. The uniforms all dirty and everything.
That was my team. My dad used to take the entire team there after every game for ice cream sodas.
And there was this dog. He had a baseball cap tied to his head like he was a mascot.
Mm-hmm.
And there was this boy, this cute boy, older than me, 12 or 13. And he gave that dog a big bowl of ice cream, just like the other boys.
That was me.
And your dog?
Yeah, my dog, Red.
You don't see markings like that in a Dalmatian very often.
No. No, I know, you don't.
He looks like the one from that day.
Yeah, on Old Mill Road. I know.
You don't think it's him, do you?
In you go. Ah. Couldn't be. Could it? So I guess I'll see you next lesson.
2 weeks. Both be married.
I can't believe you knew.
Not the whole time.
Well, why didn't you tell me?
I would have, but I couldn't.
Why not?
I swore on the Thornbirds.
What?
So when are you gonna tell her?
I'm not gonna tell her.
But she's the...
What am I supposed to say? Excuse me, Dana. We've met twice. Once when you were trapped in a burning car, and once with my dog, who was the reason you were trapped in the burning car. And after these two chance meetings, I'd like you to know that I think I'm in love with you. Gotta go over real big.
What if she...
What if she doesn't feel anything?
No,
she'll think I'm crazy. I am crazy. Can't even think about telling Dana. I can't tell Tina either. I can't marry Tina if I'm in love with Dana, because that would be worse, telling her I love someone else. I can't cancel the wedding either, because that'll hurt Tina's feelings. That's the last thing I want to do. Last thing I want to do.
The Andersons next to the Brownings.
Her false teeth.
In a glass on the table.
We have to.
We can't.
Sure, sure.
Anything what about the Abbotts?
With the Barnwells.
Yes.
Do you think we can?
Do you?
Yes.
Me too.
What in the world are you two doing?
Oh, seating arrangement.
For the wedding.
Well, you're certainly having fun.
Is Mike coming?
No, I've barely seen him. We've both been so busy, and he doesn't like this kind of stuff anyway.
Yeah, he's happy working on his car, with his head buried in a pan of motor oil.
Yeah, eating sloppy joes for dinner and sugar frosted flakes for dessert.
Watching a Jean-Claude Van Damme marathon on cable?
Yeah, anything but this.
Anything.
At least you have Paul.
Yeah, he's been helping me a lot.
Well, I'm happy to do it. I like this kind of stuff.
Honey, I know it's only a week before the wedding, but there's something very important I have to tell you. Tina, I can't marry you. I don't love you the way that I should, the way you deserve to be loved. Honey, I know this is hard for you, but please say something. Oh, man. It's never gonna work.
What's never gonna work?
Tina, I need to talk to you.
I need to talk to you too. You haven't been happy. And neither have I.
I know.
It feels like...
Like we're not right anymore.
I have feelings for someone else. I don't know what they mean. And how can I have them? And aren't I supposed to have them for you? What happened?
I don't know. First it was easy. And it was familiar. And it was expected. Somehow along the line, shared memories. I guess that's not enough.
No, I don't think it is.
Wow.
I know. I decorated your whole house. I want you to like it. I always wanted you to like it. Do you? I mean, really, do you?
I
mean...
I do. No, really, I do. I like it very much.
I'm gonna, go see, Paul. He can help me undo the wedding and the arrangements and everything. You know, he's... really good at that, and he likes it.
Yeah. Yeah, he does.
You're not mad?
No. No. No, I'm not mad. I just meant... I really hope it works out. I get to see you. Wouldn't that have been good?
Yeah, it would. It would.
Ah.
I just saw him. He's getting married on the 28th.
They broke up. Their wedding is off. You can't marry Phil.
They didn't break up.
Yes, they did.
Their wedding isn't off.
Yes, it is.
You know what? It doesn't matter. I'm engaged and I'm getting married on the 28th.
You can't.
It's for the best, Corey. Don't you understand? This is a good thing. The church is booked. The invitations are out. Oh, goodness. 300 people are coming. And Cutter's in. Cutter's in. I mean, don't just book a place like Cutter's Inn at the last moment. You have to have a man like Bob Nelson make a call for you. And my dress, my incredibly big dress. Do you know it's a 2-year wait for a dress that big? Even Valerie McFarland of the Briarwood McFarlands had to wait. But Stu Harrigan made a call to Gloria. And the flowers and the band and the caterer, it's all arranged. Phil did everything, and I can't let him down. Don't you understand? I don't want to let him down. Corey, I'm not in sixth grade. I have responsibilities. I'm all grown up. I'm engaged. I'm marrying Phil. That's it? I'm marrying Phil. Yeah.
They were wrong. It wasn't her. The birth mothers have to be registered, too, and...
She's not registered.
She probably doesn't know about it. It's not that she isn't looking for me. She just isn't looking for me there. If I go to Seattle, I can find out where she went. I can find her myself.
Don't go, Corey.
There's no reason for me to stay.
There's one reason for you to stay.
Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless this joining together of Phil and Dana in holy matrimony.
This is crazy. She's at the church getting married right now. What are we doing here, huh? What? What? All right, we'll take a look around.
The union of husband and wife in heart, mind, and body is intended by God for their mutual joy. And it is this God-given joy that will nurture them through their lifetime together.
Can we go home now? What? Hey, hey! What are you doing?
Hey!
Can't hurt to knock.
Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Phil and Dana now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they should not be married, speak now or else forever hold your peace.
You go first.
Phil, I'm so sorry, but I can't marry you.
I know.
You deserve someone who... You deserve a wife who wants all the things in life that you want. I can't be that for you.
You've changed. I keep trying to change you back.
You deserve better.
So do you.
Are you gonna be okay?
Are you?
Yeah. Pastor Harlow, I'm leaving. Thank you so much for everything.
You're welcome.
Slight change of plans.
Guess I was hoping for a miracle, huh?
What are you doing here?
I didn't get married.
I didn't either.
I've always loved you.
Corey? Leaving?
Yeah.
Seattle? Well, I'm not very good at saying goodbye. I always start to cry. So I think I'll just tell you how wonderful it's been having you in my life and being a part of yours. And if I thought it was for your best, honey, I'd adopt you myself. I'm past those years now. You don't want to be raised by your Aunt B anyway. Before you go, there's a woman inside who'd like to be your foster mother. I think you should meet her.
Just go.
Corey, I didn't get married. I was going to, but then...
You could live with us.
What do you say, pal?
Yeah! Wow! Look at that!
Like it?
It's great! Hi, Lucky. Hi, boy.
So, where do you want to go?
We could take Lucky to the park.
Take him to the lake.
Whatever you want to do. It's up to you.
Can we drive by Laura's house?
You got it.